guys, welcome to part 5 of Let's Play the Old Republic for the Imperial Agent. This actually may or may not be the finale episode. Unfortunately, I really enjoy making the series, but it doesn't seem like a lot of people have been watching or interacting with it, so like I always say on my channel, I want to make content that you guys want to see. Part 4 got, I think, the lowest views of any of my videos and no comments. So I think, I'll change up this episode to see maybe, if I do another format, people will like it more. But, I don't want to post a bunch of content that people don't like. So I'll stick to my other, real world videos. So if you like the series, definitely let me know. A few people are, really want me to continue, then I'd be happy to, because like I said, I enjoy making it, but, I don't want the, I don't want to just be, like, spamming everyone's inbox with videos that people aren't liking. But this episode, instead of doing my normal 45 minutes, I'm going to try to do the full planet of Dromund Kaas from start to finish. So, instead of just, like, random parts, it'll be like, oh, you can watch the full planet here. And maybe you guys will like that more. Maybe more people will be into it. But if people want the series to continue, super happy to continue it. But, if not, I have no problem making this the finale. And I think it was a lot of fun while it lasted. So, anyways, sorry for that long intro. Let's get into it. So, if you remember last time, we didn't progress the story. We just did the Blackdown flashpoint and got, I think, 3 levels. I think we got from level 12 to 15. Let's see. I don't think that's anything relevant. And we are 1 level away from being able to use our onslaught jacket. So hopefully we get that by the time we show up to Imperial Intelligence. Now I'm also pretty sure that, of course, our luck is after I spent all that time spending, like, an hour looking for good armor for us. They literally added back the exact armor I was looking for. So that's, like, typical. Typical my luck. So I might end up purchasing that, in all honesty. Just in case, like, you can purchase it for all your characters, just in case they remove it again and I make another agent at some point and I want the Imperial armor, but I also might purchase it just for, like, the gloves or the boots or something, because right now I don't think these gloves are going to match, with the armor we have picked out, match, not necessarily color, because you can change the color, but talking more like the bulkiness of it. I think when I put on the onslaught jacket, it was really bulky and ugly. Anyways, I just talked through that. We're now on Dromund Kaas. So I think we head over to the console, and maybe I'll spend some time on Dromund Kaas, attacking random mobs near the starter area, so I can try to get enough XP to level up as soon as we hit Imperial Intelligence.
Surprises me how clean you people keep your spaceports. If this were Hutta, I'd be scraping alien gunk off my boots. Of course, if this were Hutta, I couldn't be thrown into prison for spitting the wrong way. So come on, Agent. You're going to welcome me here to the Imperial homeworld?
I'm surprised you've never been here before.
I avoid Imperial space. I want to die in a cantina fight, not ticking off some bureaucrat. Anyway, let's head down to the city.
Don't worry. This should be fun.
Now let's go meet your boss.
Alright, headed over to Kaas City. Let's see, how much experience are we gonna get? Only 8,000 points, which is nowhere near enough. Let's, see if we can rectify that. think as soon as we go outside, we're gonna get some experience for like discovering, quote unquote, a new area. Like whenever you uncover the map, it gives you experience. But we also got some mobs over there. There we go.
They ready for us?
I don't think they are. Okay, these are our own missions. For not getting experience. I thought it was 7 levels, but apparently I'm not getting any at 5, so I guess it's higher. Or I guess it's lower than 7. I mean, maybe it's just 5. Who knows? What do you guys think of Dromund Kaas? It's like a rainy, almost like a rain. I'll throw that. we are now. Then we discovered something. Yeah, we're gonna level up. Cool. Oh man, we might level up before we even finish the mission. The light side is victorious. I never know what this is. It's something light versus dark. Alignment of people. Sorry about my chair. If people want me to continue, like I talked about in the beginning,
you would do so too.
I'll put some
fear of being humiliated.
WD-40.
Satisfaction is clear, General. It will be remedied. Now I'm asking you humbly to leave. These people are suffering in your presence.
I will leave my domain at the moment of my choosing, Keeper. You, Agent, you were the one sent to Hutter.
That's correct, my lord.
I am Darth Jadis.
I don't like what I said, my lord. Why couldn't I just say again? Why couldn't I just say yes?
How do you mean exactly?
All will become clear in time. Keeper, you will use this one. He will complete the assignment as I have instructed.
He's quite capable, my lord, but he lacks experience.
Oh, whatever.
A seasoned agent.
I have made my situation resolved before I leave Dromund Kaas.
Very well. Congratulations, Agent. You've made a friend on the Dark Council. I don't envy you.
Believe me, sir, it wasn't by choice.
I imagine not, but there's nothing to be done about it. I want you outfitted and ready to leave as soon as possible. Grab your equipment from the once we're through with your debrief.
Actually, that's kind of cool. I'm literally gonna upgrade my armor, and he's like, grab your equipment. Wow, that actually works out incredibly well. I swear I didn't script that, or, you know, know this was happening. Okay, let's throw this guy, actually first let's make the outfit. So, thank you. echoes. Tech from the Bad Batch. I think this is supposed to be Echo, maybe, with like the slit. So they definitely have some Bad Batch stuff. That's pretty awesome. See, how did I get... I don't know. That's odd. Okay, what if I put... Honestly, I think I kind of prefer the pants I have right now.
outside, please.
I think I look pretty sweet.
Handle your debris.
We need to talk about my terms.
I promise you, you'll be well compensated. You can discuss the details with the Watcher.
If you say so. You two have a good time.
So.
Yeah, look at my armor. That looks awesome.
Of your activities on Hutter. You were busier than I'd expected.
I got the job done. If that's a problem, you should change your expectations.
Maybe I should. You were extremely effective in your mission, and I'm impressed by your used violence as a tool and not a crutch. Not many agents find that balance so easily. So I wonder, why would you join Imperial Intelligence?
I'm a patriot. No, it looks like fun. I don't know. Let's just be mysterious for now.
Reasons. If you need details, I'm sure there's something in my dossier.
I had reasons too. It took me years to reconcile them with reality. This isn't glamorous work. We're sanitation workers. We clean up after the military and without us, though, the Empire falls apart. So we do whatever is necessary, even if it's thankless and ugly. You understand?
I understand completely, sir.
I'm glad to hear it. Now, as to your next assignment. One of the mandates of our organization is to eliminate dissidents and terrorists within the Empire. We've located one cell of radicals here in the capital, working toward the violent overthrow of our government.
All right.
Do we know anything more about them?
They got terrorists and radicals.
They're unsatisfied with Imperial policies, but they're not anarchists or Republic students. At least so far as we know. We've intercepted chatter suggesting the radicals are planning a major attack soon. We'll investigate the cell and obtain its plans.
Who will I be working with?
Watcher 2, please come to my...
Watcher 2, huh? That's a pretty name. Is it Twi'lek?
It's basic. Unlike many civilizations, the Empire teaches its children how to count. Watcher 2 reporting, sir.
Leo will be your...
That was brutal.
She'll report to you and take your orders, since you seem able to handle her.
I'm making you look good, Agent.
Meanwhile, Watcher 2 will be your liaison to base. She'll stay in contact remotely and...
I've heard a lot about your species.
I'm sorry, I'm not sure what you're talking about.
An alien mind, excellent physical performance.
Alien mind?
I look forward to seeing you in action.
Watcher 2 is one of our finest analysts, a success from the government.
Watcher 2 is a racist.
Her brain is faster than most computers.
Our primary lead on the radicals is at the site of a slave rebellion beyond Kaas City. You've been outfitted with all necessary equipment already. Once you're in the...
I'll head out to meet.
Remember, you're not undercover. Identify yourself as an intelligence officer if you need to, and use the fear that you're on Imperial soil now, Agent.
Agent, I'm pleased to see you just as well, I suppose. I'm still plotting the details. So, what can I do for you?
I'm ready to get going.
I told you. I'll send you the
Jeez.
Don't I even get a clue about...
You don't take this terribly seriously, do you? Agent, just as well, I suppose.
I figure if we're working together, we should...
I already know all about you, though.
I don't know why they have this conversation.
Just as well, I suppose.
There are some things I've been wondering about Imperial...
There isn't much I can tell you that you won't find out yourself. Not...
What about Keeper?
Agent, don't get involved in that. You don't survive in this business by getting between your... Now, we've both got work to do. Contact me via holocommunicator.
Let's get this done.
Agreed.
That was weird. Sometimes, you know, because you can't pick what to say, or, you know, you only given like 3 or 4 words on what you're gonna say, and then your character says something very different than what you expected. Sometimes I just exit the conversation and try again. I don't like that he said my last name. That's not supposed to exist. I don't think there's a way I can totally delete that, unfortunately. Maybe I should look into it, but it is kind of weird that it gives all of your characters the last name, like, as if somehow they're related. Like, I don't want my characters to be related.
What does it you do around
here? Blah, 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 analyze report.
is.
You want advice, eh? People here will tell you that there's maybe no right.
Blah, blah, blah.
Who do you consider?
The Empire has a lot of a member there.
Explained how the designations work. Keeper assigns the categories. Watchers analyze data, monitor targets. Minders handle internal security. Ciphers are infiltrators. A number is just to identify individuals. It's not a rank, really. Of course, there's only one keeper. Anyway, I should get back to work.
Good man. Make sure that you don't.
Of course.
Just for showing up to Imperial Intelligence.
Always go for the quick and silent kiss.
Stim boost.
This concludes our
guess.
Business.
Sure. Not all that useful, I don't think. Oh no, it is useful. So I think there's like a rebellion or something, like a mini rebellion going on down here. In all honesty, I think based on my level, if I'm 5 levels higher than the people that I'm about to face, I might just stealth through everything. But we'll engage the first group and see if we get experience. If we don't get experience, I'll just stealth through. Sweet.
jungle set.
I'm ready. Just stand.
You may have noticed the chaos out there. There's a slave rebellion going. Our analyst charged with monitoring the rebellion is with me. His name is Lodenk Kasha.
Alright, Lodenk.
Go ahead then.
Imperial intelligence is leaving concerns about the rebellion itself to the military.
I can extract him.
Jurithus was once owned by an anti.
We questioned the slaves for.
He's gone. Dead at the hands of an over enthusiastic agent. That's why mine.
One way or another, I'll make.
Okay, we get it.
I'll get Juris.
You should find this is the only way we can learn.
Sometimes people in the game are definitely long-winded. Alright. Incapacitate the slave leader. So I think most of these guys we should be able to still. Or just.
Seen anyone zoned out like that?
I think I know you, but
I'm looking for someone.
I can help you. I don't know what to do with my head. Please.
Help me find Jurithus, and I'll help you.
Jurithus is gone. Day is gone now. It all goes so slowly. Jurithus burns and starts to look like our Colossus. Incomplete. Jurithus died fighting in the jungle. I don't remember why we were fighting. Jurithus died, I know that.
Listen to me carefully. I need to know where Jurithus died.
Jurithus died with Sathan and Raneth and Avoira.
I'll check the pile of alien corpses then. Shouldn't be too hard to find.
What should I think about now? I don't know what to do with my head. I don't know what to do with my head.
Let's see. Would he be an asset? Do we really trust him to turn himself in? Not really.
You don't have to think anymore.
I don't have to think. Thank you.
Cripes. Don't even think he...
so I think... maybe if he was a useful or like higher up, he would be an asset to keep. Let's see, Watcher 2 has authorized me to translate Pomarnik's using names.
Do you have any updates for me? Put me through.
You're to suspend all field operations.
I wasn't expecting to hear.
Watcher 2 is still your liaison to base, but I want Darth Jadis wants to speak with you.
Okay. Oh,
Darth Jadis experienced his power. I said.
Why would he want to?
I told you on Hutter that he would reward him. We'll resume operations when he said.
Well, that didn't sound. Still, powerful men are the same across the galaxy. I'll bet your life that whatever else Jadis is, he's a powerful man too.
Interesting. Oh, I bet the previous agent that we saw killed this guy.
Remain outside. The Master has not requested her presence.
Looks like I'll have to miss this one then. Really?
I'll meet you when we're done.
Sure thing, Agent.
Come, stand before me and revel in the power of the Dark Council. Allow your body to betray you. Allow your blood to boil and your heart to slow. Everything that is not of the dark side will be purged, or it will be tainted. This is inoculation, Agent. This is a sacred rite. You are privileged.
Should we do it? This is a bunch of hokum nonsense.
Your parlor tricks don't frighten me, Lord Jadis.
Adolescent defiance will not serve you here. When the time comes, you will beg to feel my power again. But that is not why I summoned you. This is your due. Yourself by outmaneuvering the Hunts. I sense your uncertainty. You wonder why I involve myself in this affair. Why I take an interest in you and Imperial intelligence.
I have to admit the question crossed my mind.
Many in the Dark Council hold themselves above the mundane business of the Empire. I believe this is a mistake.
This guy, we must spread the light
of the Sith to the Empire.
How does he see?
Plant terror and hatred in every heart. I believe in the democratization of fear. But these dissidents threaten all progress.
Whatever that means.
They would reduce our world to ash and raise nothing in its place.
What do they want?
They want what children want. Unlimited, for do not underestimate our enemies. They are powerful. And they're about. I chose you for this assignment. Not only because of your successes, but because you are an outsider, an alien whom your superiors disdain and overlook. Your loyalty is uncompromised.
Interesting. I wonder what they would say. I've definitely made human agents before, and I don't remember what he says. Or maybe he doesn't say this at all.
I believe I understand.
Watch those around you, and trust no one. I will leave Dromund Kaas soon aboard the starship Dominator. I will will travel with 1,000 dignitaries, diplomats, and slaves, and show them the galaxy as I envision it. When I return, I expect the dissidents to have been purged. Kneel before.
Respect, Lord Jadis, I will not bow to you.
You do not wish to refuse me, Agent. Consider your...
No, fuck
it. Your puppet. Do what you will.
Then consider this a small example of my power. When you awaken, remember it as the price of arrogance.
Maybe that doesn't make sense in character for an intelligence officer, but, you know, I just wanted to see what, I remembered what happened, but I just wanted to see what he would do.
I'm here. What's the situation?
This is Watcher 2. We're still working on full analysis of the slave's files, but we have a new lead. Proceed to the Nexus Room Cantina in Kaas City.
I'll be there shortly.
Sure, you're ready to socialize.
Ready to socialize. Got a new pair of pants.
Two, signal established. I've tapped into the Cantina Holocans agent. I can see you from six different angles. We're ready to go.
Give me the rundown.
So, Theodore Lindak is a genius inventor and entrepreneur working with the Radicals. Unfortunately, Theodore is being sheltered by the Sith Lord Grathan. Grathan turns a blind eye to Theodore's affiliations in exchange for weapon designs.
First Darth Jadis, now Lord Grathan. Starting to dislike Sith politics.
Watch yourself. Statements like that reflect badly on an intelligence agent, and all of this is on record. Dealing with Grathan directly isn't an option. He's involved in a power struggle with the other Dark Lords. In essence, he's gone rogue. However, Theobald's daughter, Samara, frequents this cantina. She has access to Theobald's workshop in Grathan's estate.
I'll talk to her.
Samara Mingdak is rich, young, and willing to flaunt her advantages. She's popular with the Kaas City elite, but hardly beloved. No meaningful connection. Our profile suggests she'll cooperate if given incentives. I've located her in a private lounge. It's up to you how to handle her.
She won't be a problem.
Once Samara's told you how to reach her father's workshop, head to Lord Bratton's estate. Send us anything you find on Theobald's computers.
Consider it.
Go.
I think, as I progress, you know, I'm kind of figuring out the character's personality on the fly. I think a general disdain for Sith Lords is like maybe an interesting character trait that we'd always have, maybe for one reason or the other. I almost fell off. Would have been embarrassing. What's over there, Sith Inquisitor? Keep saying Inquisitor.
What good a Mandalorian if they can't escort a few trade shipments? It's not like we need them for the war.
Stop obsessing about the mercenaries, Oban. You wish you could carry a Vira blade.
You get vicious after a while, don't you?
Sure. I'm going to go talk to someone else now.
She's a brat, but she's got spirit. Wanna break?
Look at you. Enjoying yourself. Not the worst party I've ever been to. It needs improvement, you know?
I know what you mean. But things are looking up now.
I get that a lot. Not usually from guys like you, though. Military guys, I mean.
You are military, right? Not a lot of aliens walk in here without a shadow.
I mean, could you tell by the rank bars on my chest?
Let's say you're right. Does that have an appeal?
Maybe it does. Depends if you're more than just pretty skin and eyes.
Samara, be careful. You need to take this seriously.
Yeah. Shut up, Oban. I said it again. Tell me,
sorry,
how can I serve the Empire?
I came looking for a dangerous man, but I suspect you're much better company.
Oh, forward. I like that. Though, my dad doesn't approve of military guys. Hard to know what they're really after.
Your father is my target.
Yeah, I'm not interested in your father. Right now, I'm just interested in you.
No, I don't think you are. It's him you're interested in, isn't it? He's with Lord Grathen these days. Anyway, if you want to talk to Theovore, not sure what I can do. He isn't seeing a lot of visitors.
I think you can help me. Give me a few hours and I think you'll be begging to help.
Oh my god.
Listen up, I'm pretty, but I'm not dumb. My father's inventions made us rich, so I don't want that taken away. No government seizure. I want all his credits, all his property transferred to my accounts. Seem like a good deal?
Let's get a little weird. I'm gonna give up and try again.
What put a Mandalorian to
the stop?
You can.
Let's get back to where we were. I think.
I'll give you one.
Let's say you're right.
Maybe it does.
Tomorrow.
Shut up, Oban. So, tell me.
I came. What's your father so worried about people finding?
I get it. It's him you're interested in, right? He's with Lord Grathen these days. Anyway, if you want to talk to Theovore.
What do you want in return for helping us?
My father's inventions made us rich, so I don't want that taken away. No government seizure, okay? I want all his credits, all his property transferred to my...
Watcher 2, I assume you're following along.
If the information pans out, we'll give you what you want, Samara.
Well, okay, good. Theovore's workshop is in Lord Grathen's estate. It's sealed tight. I'll give you my codes, but you still need a guard's keycard.
We're finished here. Stay out.
Fine.
Okay. I think that made sense. As far as like a story perspective, you know, like try the flirt aspect and then it's clear she's not, you know, she's interested but not going for it. And then, you know, from there just sort of give her what she wants, which is credits. Suspicion among Lord Grathen's people, you know. If she gets the credits that she wants and some of my characters. Honestly, I'm not going to do it on the agent, I don't think. It does kind of come up here and there again. You can, like, there's a few unique dialogue options if you do it later with, like, the Revan expansion. But overall, it just, like, is not something that my character would really care about or participate in. So, anyways, you talk to this guy. The guy we're looking for.
Do you want to bet this ends badly?
Those were my daughter's access codes you used. Whatever you've done to her, I'll have my revenge.
I've done absolutely nothing. Oh, I gotta say hello there.
You must be Theodore Minday. I've heard a lot about you.
You didn't say hello there.
You must be one of the little sadists from Imperial Intelligence. People took away my wife, stole her from my house one night, and my only daughter grew up to be worthless, and now you've...
You're a crazy old terrorist.
I'm a father and a patriot, and you're...
If you say so, man.
Files. Don't like what I'm seeing. There's a timetable.
Head there immediately.
I'll see you soon, Agent.
And that, you know, that took us like 10 seconds, and now we're heading back to base. But, like, if we were doing all of the other quests, you know, like the side quests, not even the planetary arc, I don't think goes.
Archer 3, I need that link up to the Dominator.
Establishing holiday.
Glad you found the time to pay us a visit, Agent. Take your place. The briefing starts now.
I didn't realize I was...
Sorry, Agent.
Lord Davis, are you receiving our transmission?
I am. Proceed, Keeper.
Very well. You all know we've been attempting to determine the Dissident's plan of attack. Thanks to recent operations, we have the information.
By me.
Unfortunately,
give me credit, come on,
Keeper. Expected. A major strike is imminent. The Dissidents are targeting the ancient power conduits that run beneath the capital.
Their intention is to overload the power grid, causing a cascade failure that would detonate the power relay stations. The resulting explosions would kill hundreds of people, and the blackout would leave us vulnerable to further attacks.
Sir, are there access points to the power grid under military control?
All but one. The terrorists intend to access the power conduits through the Dark Temple.
Sorry to interrupt. What's the Dark Temple?
I'll sum up for those of you unfamiliar with the history. The Dark Temple predates Dromund Kaas' colonization.
That was so dorky. I can't do that.
Watcher 3, I need that link up.
Sorry.
I'll sum up for those of you unfamiliar with
this. He said the exact same thing anyways.
The Dark Temple predates Dromund Kaas' colonization. It was sealed by the Sith during the city's construction. When the Dark Council opened it some months back, they found it inhabited by force-driven phenomena.
Whereas we saw the Dark Temple as a threat to be contained, the Dissidents saw the temple rest directly above a key power junction. If the Dissidents can push past the, phenomena, they can access the grid.
These Dissidents have been planning. They have supplies, maps, and weapons, and they're not counting on making it out alive. This is a suicide run.
That won't make things easy. They'll only fight harder.
We have security footage of Dissidents heading toward the Dark Temple. A full squad of operatives will pursue the...
No.
My lord.
This sacred ground, and will not be unduly disturbed. My agent will go alone.
I'm honored by your choice.
Oh my god.
Watch
I just
three,
wanted to
and
say
that link up to the Dominator.
I if Lord don't Davis like going alone and out. Almost prefer it, but instead I stand in my honored by your choice, my lord. Okay, remain silent. Remain silent.
I won't make
us no.
My lord.
Make sure the job is done.
My lord,
that's
I strongly urge you to reconsider. If the dissidents succeed, we...
The spirits of the temple must not be disturbed. Not by terrorists, and not by Imperial intelligence. One agent will suffice. My role here is finished. Do as I will, Keeper.
Very well. The decision is made. You will go to the Dark Temple, stop the radicals from reaching the conduits and detonating their charges.
Let's get this done.
Good man.
We'll monitor you as long as we can, but the temple blocks most...
Luck to you too.
Go on, the Dark Temple is waiting.
Okay. A bad jacket. Thank you for that. I certainly appreciate it. Alright, so we're heading over to the Dark Temple. Which of course sounds very menacing.
Some information you may be interested in.
Okay.
We've concluded our business.
City. And then we'll take the speeder car over. just discovered this guy. Is it gonna unlock? There we go. And we got, I don't know, a couple thousand XP. We can go to the next spot. And then, yeah, this is the last location at Dromund Kaas, so it'll probably be, I think, maybe another 45 minutes to an hour before we're totally done with the planet and on our personal starship. Maybe that was a spoiler. Well, if you didn't know, after you finish Dromund Kaas, you get a personal starship. And we'll probably get to level 19 or 20. Oh yeah, here's like the tunnel that you go through. Again, you would have to walk all the way through this stuff. Thank you. cutscene's kind of useful, hit and run. Let's go with that for now. Alright. Interesting. What did I just complete? What just happened?
Military? I heard the shots, but I wasn't sure. I can't believe you actually followed us in here. None of us are gonna make it back out, you know that, right?
I know you're one of the terrorists. Tell me what's happened.
I'm one of the terrorists, all right. Like everyone you kill. That's why we decided to make a stand. To terrorize. I'm the last one. A dozen of us came into the temple and the rest are dead. Or gone. Same with you, I guess.
You should have known you couldn't pull this off. What did you mean to accomplish?
To show the Emperor what it means to fight for freedom. And we still will. You can shoot me now. You can save the power grid, preserve the Imperial lifestyle for a little longer. But there are other cells. They'll keep fighting.
What other cells are you talking about?
Other cells, other planets.
Imagine
this
if they just killed
the tip of the iceberg.
That'd be the worst.
There's worse coming. But that's all you're going to learn. You can't stop me. You have to kill me. Shoot me now, Imperial, before the ghosts get into your head.
You don't care if the ghosts get into my head. You're worried they'll get into yours.
Yes, damn you! That's not how I want to go. I saw what happened to my friends. I took comfort in the fact that I'd die when we took out the power grid. Have mercy. Kill me now before the ghosts come.
Might as well not leave any loose ends.
I'll make it quick.
Thank you.
I still have absolutely no clue what happened with that, those two quests that got completed, and I got a lot of really good gear. Like, look how much better all this is than the gear I had.
Always go for the quick and silent kill.
Oh, Snipter.
Not
the useful little thing. People use that a ton in operations and flashpoints and put someone to sleep for 60 seconds. And you use it in stealth and it doesn't reveal you. So you can like use a sleep dart on an enemy and your teammates can
sleep down over the city. From that height and at that velocity, the collateral damage alone could cost millions.
If the reactor core was breached, the radiation damage will...
I don't care about the radiation damage, dammit. Get me security footage, communications logs, something we can use.
Shouldn't someone be celebrating our successful return?
All military channels are reporting in. The Dominator has been completely destroyed.
That's exciting.
What's the situation?
It's good to see you. There was a secondary target, apparently.
Watcher 2, I still need confirmation. And you, Agent, get ready to move. We need everyone operational.
Sorry, sir. But there were over 3,000 people on that ship, half of them civilians.
I'm aware of that. Do your job, Watcher 2. Run the numbers.
Lockdown procedures are in place. All traffic has been grounded.
Initial analysis is done. Cross-checking with the droids.
Getting conflicting reports from the Kaas City spaceport. I'm trying to sort it out.
Nothing could have survived that explosion. All sources confirm casualties are 100%.
Then Darth Jadis is dead.
Be that mean.
Who did this? What happened?
There was an explosion aboard the Dominator.
I'll say it later, privately.
But it has to be connected to the dissidents. Darth Jadis was leaving on a special tour of the Empire. He brought military personnel, civilians, and Sith to his flagship as part of some grand vision. Now they're all dead.
Even more the dead later. For now, stay focused on the living.
I just calculated the likely circumstances of each passenger's death. Don't tell me what to focus on.
Sir, we've got a starship trying to take off. Several dissidents from the watch list are aboard. Military squads are moving to intervene.
Blow the ship to pieces. I want the terrorists alive and I want their computer intact. You fixer, do we have any SecM units available?
What? I don't...
The SecM's, the mouse droids. Find one and bring it back now.
Whatever ordeal you went through in the Dark Temple, your recovery will have to wait. I need you in the field.
I'm ready to go, sir.
One moment.
I have the droid here.
Agent, I need you to get to the city cargo port. There's a terrorist ship attempting to take off. Take the mouse droid and deliver it into one of the ship's maintenance compartments. With the droid aboard, we can disable the hyperdrive and download its computer contents.
What happens after that?
Your ship won't be able to leave this star system. Will you get going? We need you to plant that mouse droid. When you're back, we have things to discuss.
Starship gets bombed and everyone on it, including him, dies. And now, you know, the story from here progressing is basically hunting down this terrorist organization, which, as you uncover, it turns out to be quite huge, spanning across, you know, a big chunk of the galaxy. So it's not just like a Dromund Kaas, like small time operation, it's like a huge terrorist cell. So that's kind of where the agent story is going from here.
Welcome back, Agent. Excellent work out there. Absolutely excellent.
The mouse droid has just sent the contents of the ship's computer, sir. I'll send the military to pick up the dissident.
At least one thing's gone smoothly. The worst seems to have passed, but don't expect to rest anytime soon.
I'll be ready when you need me.
I know. And you will be. If Jadis dead, there'll be a mad rush to fill the power vacuum. We'll be fending off our own people with one hand and tracking down terrorists with the other.
Keeper, I'm receiving a transmission. Someone's broadcasting a holo recording to the entire Imperial Communications Network.
The terrorists want to talk. I say we should listen.
Patching it through now. I'm going to try to pinpoint the source.
Citizens of the Empire, this is the Eagle. I'm here to tell you that our government is corrupt. When the Emperor signed his treaty with the Galactic Republic, we were promised a new epoch. Glory unrivaled since the first Sith Dynasty. Instead, our empire has suffered. Apathetic moths and wicked lords of the Dark Council vie for power, while our soldiers die over worthless planets in nameless star systems.
Typical consolidationist rhetoric. Watcher 2, keep trying to find a source for the broadcast. Everyone else, start pulling up our files on the Eagle.
Wake me if he says something interesting.
We've been hearing rumors about the Eagle for years. But we never thought he could pull off anything this big. Another mistake.
Anyone who speaks out in favor of reform is
just
kidnapped and tortured by Imperial intelligence. This must not continue.
Don't call
the Ministry of Logistics reports that they can't jam the signal. Everyone in the Empire is seeing this.
A short while ago, a group of defiant revolutionaries destroyed an Imperial dreadnought. 3,000 people were aboard, including Darth Jadis, a Lord of the Dark Council. We chose to strike at Darth Jadis publicly so that every Imperial citizen would know the truth. The Dark Council is not invulnerable. We can if we regret the sacrifice of so many civilians, but it was necessary. The Empire cannot cover up this momentous event. Imperial intelligence cannot silence our call to arms.
Get to the point, you piece of filth. What is it you really want to say?
What do you mean?
Here it comes.
This is only the first step towards a better future. We have agents throughout the Empire preparing to strike again and again. We will not relent until our government chooses strength over weakness, unity over discord. We will continue to show the anger of the people. This is the Eagle. End transmission.
So, our enemy has a name.
It won't be a problem, sir.
Glad to hear it. We've made mistakes today. We underestimated the Eagle. We were too slow to eliminate the dissidents. We assumed the Dark Temple was the sole terrorist target. You performed above and beyond expectations. You showed you can handle these people, and now you're going to show us the way forward.
Sir, I don't understand. What are you suggesting?
You are going to head our operation to dismantle the Eagle's network. You will locate and eliminate his terror cells through infiltration, manipulation, and assassination.
Well, you sat on your hands,
I'm assigning you a rank and designation as suits your new position. You no longer have a name. You will answer only to Cypher 9.
I promise you won't regret this.
Congratulations, Cypher 9. You earned this.
Cypher 9, huh? Cute. But I think I'll keep calling you Agent.
With the rank comes certain privileges, including a degree of operational independence. You may recruit your own operatives, and you will be outfitted with a starship.
Watch your team, and
will remain Cypher 9's liaison to base. I assume that won't be a problem.
No problem, sir. Glad to stay a part of this operation.
Good. Begin analyzing all reports on recent dissident activity. I want a list of possible terror cell locations within the hour. Eagle says he's got agents around the galaxy. Assuming he's telling the truth, you're going to be doing some traveling.
I'm looking forward to it.
I thought you might. Your starship is at the spaceport. It's been refit and removed from public record. Watcher 2 will upload likely activity centers for the Eagle and his network. Proceed to your targets as you see fit.
Any final instructions, sir?
Be careful of these people, Cypher. Destroying the Dominator was no mean feat. Killing Darth Jadis was nearly unthinkable. But this is our job. Do whatever is required. Good luck.
We did it. Wow, that's a crappy blaster. should, or not Balmora. Oh no, it is. I think it is Balmora. Then Nar Shaddaa, Tatooine, which is of course a super famous one. Alderaan, which is the one that blew up in A New Hope. Then from Alderaan, I think it's Taris. After Taris is Quesh, and I think Hoth. Then Voss. There's a hangar. This is how you travel around to the different planets. So let's head out in our personal starship. Watch the cinematic for the first time, and then after that, just skip it every time. Oh, look at the rain. That's a kind of cool shot. And we're off. I'll be secretly coming back here.
Superior. Here to keep an eye on me, I presume.
My only directive is your satisfaction, Master. And besides, my photoreceptors are not surveillance grade. I am programmed for a wide array of tasks, including but not limited to meal preparation, ship maintenance, janitorial duty, and etiquette. Welcome aboard the X-70B Phantom, an experimental prototype resembling a luxury shuttle that conceals the combat capabilities of a heavy starfighter. Find all of the standard amenities, including your own private captain's locker for storing valuables. The astrogation console contains a constantly updated map of the known galaxy. Interstellar communications are accessed via the ship's holoturn. Priority alerts that you may find useful are available from the Imperial Holonet console. Lastly, the ship's intercom will inform your crew that you wish to issue new orders. Any questions?
You're at least capable of providing security while I'm not aboard.
I regret I am unable to offer you combat support, Master. Frankly, my chassis couldn't withstand. However, should any
errors
arise that are beneath your superior status, please do whenever you are ready to depart, consult the...
So he actually can. Oh yeah, this is talking about 15 experience points. He actually can be summoned in combat, but he doesn't shoot or anything. All he does is heal you.
More variety.
Not even. Here's what I don't get. You got a little brass, you got a little style. You're not totally one of them.
But you still play Keeper's pet. Shoot all the right people when you could work for... whoever.
I could point out that goes for you as well.
You mean you could avoid the question?
Me? I'm in long enough to lay low, pick up some cash, sort out some
What sort of personal stuff?
Made a deal with your bosses when I came on board. Now let's get back to...
That was a failed conversation. Okay, I got some experience. At least that's useful.
Hey, Stiggs. I think you got a message on that thing.
Download and begin playback.
Why is the colors that
intelligence is finalizing our target list, but in the meantime, there's a formality we need to address. With Darth Jadis' demise, his seat on the Dark Council has opened. It will be killed by his daughter and sole apprentice, Darth Jordan.
Jadis has a daughter?
Lord Jordan demands to meet with you. Proceed to Korriban at once. Oh, he has authorized your presence in the Sith Academy.
Find a seat. We leave immediately.
Give me a shout if you need something.
Should we do that? Might as well. I think the only other alternative is we end here, but I think it would be good to end. Oh yeah, here's the galaxy map. I think it would be good to end when we're like set up and ready to go to like the next real planet. Oh yeah, we can watch the hyperspace. There's Dromund Kaas. And we're in the hyperspace lane and we're already there. So pretend that was like 24 hours. So yeah, this is the planet that the Warrior and the Inquisitor start on, which is like the birthplace of the Sith, you know? So I guess it makes sense. But yeah, so I was talking about sometimes the game just sends you to like random planets to like do something quick here and there. Oh, look at that. That looks pretty sweet with the Star Destroyer.
We have a visitor.
Yes, my lord.
Commander, I want to be informal with my bodyguards.
Ah, yes, Lady Jarida.
Delightful. You, my pretty alien. Don't you find my bodyguards delightful?
I'm afraid I don't share your views.
How difficult it must be to live your life with so little taste. Delightful bodyguard, I have a request.
Yes, my lady?
Kill our visitor, please.
As you wish. He's as good as dead.
I remember this. See how far you get.
Darth Jordan, Lord of the Dark Council and successor to Darth Jadis. I
hear you're investigating my father's assassination.
The attack was a test, then.
I could sense your feelings during the fight. I think you'll do nicely tracking these terrorists. Are you really sure that this eagle killed the...
You saw his announcement. He took responsibility.
It's quite a speech. But it doesn't prove anything. Jadis believed in spreading fear and anger to every planet and species in the Empire. Even to creatures like you. Perhaps his ambitions drew too much attention. Any one of his rivals on the Dark Council might have killed him.
You're his daughter. How did you feel about him?
Oh, I hated my father. He taught me to keep my emotions seething inside and show no one. I disobeyed. Chase after you, terror. Save the lives of your Imperial friends, but if you learn who's really responsible, come to me. I've earned my place on the Dark Council, and I won't share my father's fate. Dismissed.
Cipher 9 to headquarters. You have my target list.
Roger 2 here. I've finished preliminary mapping of the Eagle's network. Your designated targets are terror cells located on Balmora near the Republic border and on Nar Shaddaa in Hutt space.
I just had a very interesting meeting with Darth Jadis' daughter. Any information on her?
I'm afraid that data isn't mission relevant. Contact me once you've arrived at either location, Cipher. Roger 2 out.
How rude. Yeah. exit the ship. Here is the cargo bay. We have Galactic Trade Market, cargo hold, and a repair astromech, engine bay room, hyperdrive, and looks like the crew quarters. Some beds and a desk. Size. Or maybe, you know, I have some like longer term projects that I've been slowly working on the channel, so maybe I record like half a day of content and then just spend a few months editing it. I'm also open to something like that. But as far as like a weekly series, I'm not sure if I can, you know, edit it every single episode.